came out 31, I had a question coming out of section 2.3, number 17. And this was when we had a woman who had $50,000 to invest. And she's going to put it into a couple of different bonds, or at least one bond and a CD. And the question was posed, hey, if she puts X amount of this money into the bond, how much will she have to put into a CD? So I'm going to do it with just smaller numbers, and then I hope that you'll see the idea. So let's say I got paid, and my paycheck had an extra $100 in it, and I want to put some of it into a bond and some of it into a CD. So let's just do something like, if I put $30 into a bond, I would then have $70 to put into a CD, right? And another scenario, let me get a different color so we can see it. If I put $40 into a bond, then I would have $60 to put into a CD. Or if I put, we'll say, $27 into a bond, I would have $73 to put into a CD. So then I could rephrase this and say something along the lines of, well, what if I put X dollars into a bond? How much would I have to put into a CD? And the thing that I'm hoping we notice about all of these is they all total out to 100, right? So if this is 30, this has to be 100 minus 30. If this is 40, if I put $40, this is 100 minus that number, right? 27, 100 minus. So if I put in X dollars, ooh, that got a little messy. Oops, all of that went away. So if I put in X dollars, I have 100 minus X dollars left over. So this woman is a high roller, right? She's got $50,000 that she's putting away. So if she puts X dollars into the bond, then she has $50,000 minus X left to put into the CD. And that's where I'm getting this expression, right? Because ultimately, if you think about this, you could say the money that she puts in the bond plus the money that she puts in the CD has to total out to $50,000. So if I put X into the bond, then 50,000 minus X is left over. And I could also get that algebraically by just subtracting X to that side. All right, so there's number 17. Thanks so much. Bye.